Hello friends, in our previous lecture I have told you the basic properties of charges and all the necessary theory about the charges, means how we can generate a charge, or can we generate a charge, what about its quantization and what is the conservation of charge. Today we will study that what kind of quantity is the charge, is it a scalar or vector. So guys, charge is a scalar quantity just because we are given the magnitude of the charge. Means somebody says that a body has 2 coulomb charge, 3 coulomb charge, 5 coulomb charge. So magnitude is over there. There is no any direction. And it also follows the algebraic sum of the mathematics. Means if there are two charges located on the body, one is plus 4q and another is plus 2q, then the net charge on the body is plus 6q. Means algebraic sum means algebraic summation means when we do any mathematical operation, we will always consider its sign of the quantity. Here is plus 4q plus 2, the resultant is plus 6. Here is minus 4, here is plus 2, the result is minus 2. So this is only the magnitude, and that's why it is a scalar quantity. But more interesting concept behind the discovery of the charge, I think you should all know that. Who discovered the charge? The discovery of charge is related with Benjamin Franklin in early 80s. He discovered all these things like charges repel, opposite charges attract. But an interesting thing is that if any inventor invents something, then he usually incorporate his name with his invention. But Benjamin Franklin couldn't do so. Even too many students don't know why he couldn't do so. Benjamin Franklin, when discovered the charges, plus charges or minus charges, why he cannot associated with his name with his invention? The reason is that the discovery of charge, or the thing here, algebraic sum, means when you define a charge, you will always need an algebraic operation. Means in chemistry, if two things are over there and they are added, you will definitely get a third thing. But in mathematics, when two, three things are added, maybe you get 0. Means plus 3 plus minus 3 is always equal to 0. The same phenomena lies in case of charges. So the discovery of charge is governed by the algebraic rules of addition. That's why he couldn't associated it name with his discovery, rather to give plus and minus sign to the charges. A very interesting answer, that why Benjamin Franklin gave plus for the charge and minus for the charge. The reason is that you will always apply a mathematical operation, which is algebraic summation, in which sign of the quantity is encountered. That's why he, means Benjamin Franklin, used a plus sign and a minus sign. So he couldn't operate his name with his invention. Now we are going to compare the charge with the mass. Is there any similarity or differences between the charge and the mass? The basic thing for a charge to exist is matter or mass. But for a mass to exist, I don't think there is any charge needed. The very first difference is that charge may be positive or negative. However, mass is always positive, means mass cannot be negative. Second one is, the electric charge on the body is independent of the speed of the body. It doesn't depend upon the speed of the body. How fast it is moving, it is not considered. But in case of masses, if a body is traveling with the speed of the order of speed of light, then its mass get increased by a factor mv equal to m0 upon under root 1 minus v square upon c square, where mv is the moving mass of the body, m naught is the rest mass of the body, v is the velocity of the body by which it is moving, and c is the speed of light. Third one is charge is always quantized. As in my previous lecture, I have told you that from the quantization of the charges, q equal to plus minus n e. A body can have plus e charge, plus 2e charge, plus 3e charge, or in turn minus e, minus 2e, and minus 3. Means charge is not continuous, but it is an integral multiple of minimum charge of the electron or proton. But mass is always continuous. It is not exist in quantized form. However, the quantization of mass is not yet known. Fourth one is the charge is always conserved. Means a charge is never lost. In turn, the mass is not conserved quantity, because mass can be converted into energy and energy can be converted into mass. A very famous Einstein's relativistic relationship equal mc square. With the help of that, mass can be converted into energy and energy can be converted into mass, and vice versa. Last one is force between two charges may be attractive or repulsive depending upon the kinds of charges that are involved. If there are two positive charges, then the force will be obviously repulsive, and if there are opposite type of charges, means one is plus and another is negative, means minus, then there will be a force of attraction. But in case of mass, the force between two masses is always a force of attraction, it is not repulsion. So all these 5 points in detail explain the basic difference between charge and mass. In my next lecture, I will go discuss the Coulomb force in vector form, its units, its effectiveness, permittivity, and all other some topics. Guys, please like, share, and subscribe my channel.